I think we have behind us an incredible year in terms of climate change science and in terms of climate change politics. As you know, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change came out this year with three very important reports. And it's not a matter of the solution not being affordable. A large part of that solution is available to us today. What we need is political will. And the big question for me is, ministers, what is your political answer to what the scientific community is telling you so very clearly? And that is an important part of what these 2 weeks here in Bali are all about. The focus of this meeting is going to be how can we take a long-term climate change regime forward. And if you've come here with the expectation that at the end of 2 weeks we will have agreed a next round of targets for industrialized countries, we will have agreed what the future engagement of developing countries is going to be, you will leave here disappointed. It is not feasible to expect that in a two-week time period you can agree a long-term political and economic response to the question of climate change. What I do hope this meeting will do are three things. First of all, I hope that this meeting, by the end of the high-level segment next week, can agree to formally launch negotiations on a long-term climate change regime. Secondly, I hope that this meeting can agree what the agenda of those negotiations needs to be. And the third important thing, which I hope this meeting will agree, is an end date for those negotiations. Not just launch them, not just agree the agenda, but also define when the negotiations need to be completed. The achievement of the Kyoto Protocol lies in the fact that it has provided very important architecture that we can build on. It's created responsibilities for governments to measure their emissions and report. It's created opportunities for countries to prepare to adapt to the impacts of climate change. It's provided capacity building facilities, but it's also created a carbon market which at the moment is worth $30 billion per year. And I think that that is architecture that we can build on going into the future. My sense is that there is an incredible growth in the international awareness of the importance of climate change. I think that there is a growing international recognition amongst the general public that politicians need to come to grips with this issue. And I think millions of people around the world, mainly through you, will be focusing their attention on what is going to be the response of the politicians to that very clear message given to them by the scientific community. Thank you.